Hello everyone. We're going to look at how to put data into tables today and look at a few examples of that. So if we take a look here, we'll give this the title of tables. Another term that's often used for this is t-charts. We can talk about t-charts instead of tables. And what that means is basically like a two-column table. So on the left side here, we might have, my age, and then over here we might have the number of gray hairs on my head. So we can really put any data into a table in some way. So, when I was 18 is when I had my first gray hairs pop up. There were maybe 10. When I turned 20, I still had about 10. 22, I was up to maybe 12. 24, I was up to 16 by then, had finished college. And it just kept going. So we can put this data into a table just to kind of organize it. Another thing that we might do is, if we're looking at a pattern, like maybe a pattern of dots like this. So first I have one dot, then I have two dots, then I have three dots. In a table, I can just write, over here I might use a word like case number or figure number. I'm just talking about like this is the first one, this is the second one, and this is the third one. And then over on the other side, I might just say the number of dots. So case one, I have one dot. Case two, I have two dots. Case three, I have three dots. And now this is the kind of data that could have a pattern to it. I mean, we start to see like probably for any case that I put, case 99, I might have 99 dots, right? And this can be even more complicated. For example, I could draw a pattern that maybe looks something like this. And then that's my first one. And then maybe in the second one, it gets a little bit bigger. So that might be my second one. And then maybe my third one gets even bigger. Something like this. And I can put this information into a table too, right? So again, I might say case number over here, the number of dots over here. In case one, I can count up the dots. I have seven. Case two, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And then in case three over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. And you might see a pattern to that as well. So that's, just one way that we might look at a pattern of dots and put it into a table. But we can really do this with anything, which I think is kind of cool. I could take a look at, some penguins, and I could make a table of the first result that I have over here. This one has one penguin. And then I might say in my second result, I have three penguins. Now over here, I have five penguins that I can see. And the next one, it's a whole lot of penguins, right? But I can do this with anything, ice cream, one scoop, Three scoops, three scoops. Basketballs. And I could start to even make my own patterns, you know, like this one. Case one, I have one basketball. Two, I have two. And to make this into a table, or to make any of these patterns into a table, I'm just going to take the case number on the left-hand side and write the number of basketballs or penguins or dots or gray hairs on the right-hand side. So you could make a pattern for any of these, you can make a table for any of these patterns of basketballs.